What is up, guys? Psycho Sam and Gaming back again. Episode 2, Part 2, No Man's Sky. I'm about 2 hours into the game or so, I would say. Maybe roughly an hour and a half. And it's definitely growing on me. So in this episode, well, first off, I ended episode 1 at trying to get my ship repaired and thrusters online and everything. And you'll also notice something different here. I got a different ship. Apparently, if you pre-order the game and you come over here to your options, down to redeem bonus content, you'll have this ship, this Horizon Omega ship. And basically, it'll tell you to transfer all of your stuff from your inventory of your abandoned ship into this one and take this Omega ship. So to me, I mean, it's your personal opinion. I think it looks a little cooler, but it's up to you guys. So basically, in this episode, or in this part two of this series, I'm fixing to take off. I am ready. I have everything online. I'm ready to leave the planet. My thrusters are a go. Everything's good to go. This is my first time ever flying. I don't know what this is going to be like. I may crash this shit, epically burn, and maybe stuck on this planet. But I don't know what's going to happen. So, in this episode, I'm just going to give you guys my opinion and my review. And it's just based off of an hour and a half, 2 hours of the game. I don't really have that much time in it. And it's by far the biggest game that's ever been made as far as planets and, you know, sheer size of it. These planets are to scale. But I'm going to give you my personal opinion based off of 2 hours, which probably isn't much. But when I first started the game, the first 10, 15 minutes, honestly, I was lost. There is no direction. You just go out and aimlessly start blowing shit up and collecting resources. And then eventually, over time, you'll start learning what needs to be done. There are objectives and you get milestones, but there's no real storyline. There may be per se, but to me, storyline gives you direction. This doesn't really give you direction. This is just an explorer type game. So after I played around with it, I finished my part one. I played some more with it and got my everything I needed to get my ship going. I started to enjoy it more. And this is just one planet I'm stuck on right now. So we're fixing to leave. We're going to get into space for the first time. I'm anxious to see what space looks like. And I really do hope you guys enjoy. I'll give it more reviews as this episode goes through. And just to basically talk about the game and whether or not you should buy it, what type of games you, if you like these types of games. It's nothing like Elite Dangerous, it's nothing like Star Citizen, by no means whatsoever. So I can't even compare the two. This really is nothing. I can't really compare this game to anything. It's set in a world by itself, or an 18 quintillion world if you want to be technical. But I do enjoy it. It's only 2 hours, so it's growing on me. But I ain't gonna lie, it is hard starting out. And that may be just me, but it was difficult. So it's turning daylight now. So let's get up in the air, let's start flying, and let's get into space and let's see what we can get into. If you guys like the video, as always, please subscribe to the channel. This is a series, it may be a long one. So we're gonna throw these videos out there for you guys' enjoyment, and hopefully my gameplay videos will help you determine if you want to buy the game or not. And if you have any comments or questions, please leave them down below, and I'll try to get to you guys. So let's get started. So that's what happens when you get a milestone. So you get. So I'm flying with my mouse and keyboard, and it's not that bad, honestly. Let's exit the atmosphere. And I think my first objective here, I'm going to try to find some kind of Atlas station. I'm trying to, anyway. So we're boosting out. And this boost looks nothing like Star Citizen. Star Citizen is a lot more. This is kind of not really cartoony. It doesn't really have a Borderlands feel. Alright, so I just boosted out. have no idea where to go. Flying is kind of funky. Space station. Or we're gonna try to anyway. I don't know how much fuel I have. So I'm moving my mouse. So once I guess you're in hyperspace, that is your direction. You can't change direction, which makes sense because you would probably burst into particles and your ship would probably be destroyed. So my fuel is definitely going down. I have to get to this space station really quickly. Flying right now, it's taking control of itself, so that's probably for the best. That would be pumping all in any close of shit. Alright, we're docked. So let's see how much we can interact with these space stations here. Oh, in an Atlas pass. Okay. So I'm not quite sure how to get that Atlas pass. We got it here. I guess now I need to go and try to find an Atlas pass. Now I did find a red sphere that said something about Atlas when I was on my ship. I mean on my planet, the first planet I was on, but I accidentally clicked the wrong damn thing. Assuming all of these bright stars are you can visit. Thank you. blast into the atmosphere. Lesson learned. Don't land your ship in fucking trees and shit. So let's see what happens when you die. Ship gets busted to shit. That's what happens. And then I'm already on a toxic ass planet, so I'm probably gonna have to stay kinda close to my ship. I do it too much, freaking asshole will come and start shooting at me. So I may have to make a shelter here. Let's see if I can. I didn't try this, let's try this first. Colonial output. Factory, 43 minutes, okay. Yeah, right. Being curious right now, guys. I'm just trying to. Apparently, you can find places with these signal scanners. Let's try Monolith this time. I know where that shelter is. I don't know what's gonna happen with Monolith, though. Okay, it's ancient alien. I know I could charge that. Mighty Beam's about to die though. I'm going to charge that up.
Technology recharge. Technology recharge.
Basically, destroying your ship obviously strands you on the planet that you're on. And it all depends on what kind of planet it is, whether or not you can survive on it. This is a pretty toxic planet. And my exosuit is dropping really fast. I found out if you press F, hold it down, you can analyze the animals and plants if you haven't already discovered, and you get credits for it. Sometimes. Not all the time. First and second episodes here, I had actually had a sentinel come and attack me, and I had to kill him. And I ran back to my ship to hide because I didn't know if they were sending more or not. Looks like that was the only one I had to kill aboard them ever since. So, and that's because I was mining too much of the planet. So you have to be careful how much. You have to be careful how much you mine. one of mine too much. I track, I don't know what that was. This game makes a lot of weird noises.
Received.
lot. He's playing this fuck up. You're not paying attention.
Try to get to that
Thadmi, what's it called? Damium. Just need that red shit. Red missile. It's probably a way I can find it. This is what most of my episodes are gonna probably consist of for now. Just running around doing nothing that's entertaining. So I apologize in advance. Probably gonna be boring until I get myself established in this game. Figure out what the hell is going on. But I guess my ship crashing was unexpected event. It kind of changed the direction I wanted to go early on. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to cut the video and try to get my ship repaired. And try to find a warp cell and I'll give you guys that information. In my third episode, where to find a warp cell. Warp cell, that's one of the things I need to get my ship back online. So you guys just stay tuned. I'll be back with part 3 as soon as I can put it up, as soon as my ship gets up and I'm ready to fly again. That'll be my start of episode 3. So appreciate you guys watching the video. Please subscribe, leave comments, questions down below, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Psycho Sandman Gaming, it's been a pleasure.